Hi everyone, welcome to the introduction of Git and GitHub tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to cover overview of Git and GitHub. Why do we need Git? Let's think about what will happen if we don't use Git. Think about you are working on your school project without Git, which I also have experienced before. You may have multiple files like this example. You email the file to your team member and your friend email you updated one. You will end up in your folder with multiple files like version 1, version 1 update by John, version 1.1 backup file, which looks very messy to me. This is not only a messy issue, but also there are many risks from handling important file like this. If this is a school project, you may be fine, but you may want to manage it better than this if you are working on the real project from your company. I list risks here. Multiple files for one file sounds bad. You don't know who updated this file, even you don't know why this file has been updated. And yes, Git will perfectly resolve these kind of issues, and that is the reason why you are listening to this tutorial now. So let's use Git with the same example. You have a project requirement file in project directory where there is no Git here. So first, let's initiate Git in this directory. Once you command Git init, in this project directory, you will see newly created .git directory. The .git directory is for staging and local repository, which I will explain sooner. Congratulations, that means your project directory now successfully in Git management. Git has three tiers, as you can see here. The first one is we call the directory itself from your PC or Mac as working directory where the file physically located at. And the working directory includes .git directory where staging and local repository at. And the second one is the staging where file cache stays right before going to the local repository. Third is the local repository, like a database where stores file revisions. Let's take a look on an example here. Once you command git add, the project requirement file will be snapshot and staged in the staging area. You can double check if the file is in the staging area by commanding git status. Once the file is in the staging area, you can now store the file in the local repository. Command git commit will store your file in git local repository. When you commit, you'd better give a proper commit message for the future with regards to the history management. Once you commit, since your git local repository has the file, since now you don't have to worry about the file in your working directory. If you want to update the file, command git checkout to download latest version of the file. And you can follow the same steps git add and git commit to update the version to git local repository. So have I told there is a way to give message during commit? Giving commit message helps you to understand why the file has been updated. Also, you can check out any version of the file. In this example, you can check out the version 2 while latest version is the 3. So now, we have taken a look at a simple example of Git file management. To sum up, Git has a working directory, staging, and local repository. But I'm for sure the main reason why you listen to this tutorial is collaborate with your team member using GitHub. Then what is GitHub? No problem, you are almost there. GitHub is a remote repository. Have I told you remote repository? Yes, I told you. In the Git architecture, we store the file in local repository in this Git architecture. GitHub is a cloud remote repository where you can share local repository to the public. So, let's take a look at this extended diagram here. Do you see what is new from this diagram? You can see the remote repository where you can push your files to also where you can pull some files from. So push means upload to the GitHub and pull means download file from the GitHub. But push and pull means more than the uploading and downloading, because it is Git. That means all the file version and history are managed by Git. So this picture will give you more GitHub perspective understanding. Any user who installed Git in their PC or Mac can easily pull the code from the GitHub and make a change and push it to the GitHub, which is the remote repository from your local repository. And GitHub's one of the powerful features is branching. Branching is one root directory has all your project file changes, and there's a way to have copy same branches as yours. Here example, let's assume all your team member works on the master branch. If you are working on the master branch and mistakenly push the compile error code, all members will be affected by your mistake. The safe way not to affect your team member is branching out. Branching out means you have your own branch from master branch. Here you create feature branch from master branch. Now feature branch has all the latest changes from the master branch. By branching out to your own branch, you can make sure you any crazy change doesn't affect to master branch. Your friends should be good now. Once you made all the changes for your feature, you will have merge request to master, and like this example, your team member will review your changes, and when they approve, your branch can be merged into master branch. So here is the summary. Git is version management tool using local repository. GitHub is remote repository for collaboration by multiple Git users. Next, we will have 5-minute practice video tutorials for Git commands. Thanks, and see you on the next video.